bone.
And now, straight from the basement of my house, everybody over there listen up, cause it's time for that T-Bone talk.
Hi, and welcome to T-Bone Talk. I'm your host, T-Bone. Today on my show, I will be discussing a very popular style of music, which is called rap. I will discuss the major historical events which influence rap, what the music says about society, and three famous rappers. Also, I will talk about the lyrics and give some examples. But before I get started, I would like you to take a look at this special report from the news.
For a minute. They first started calling it rap in the late 70s when New York musicians playing something called hip-hop music started kind of chanting the lyrics to songs instead of singing them. It was popular in dance clubs then, and that's about all. But now, this.
It's a message being sent out to the black community, you know, behind a beat.
You got a low rider bin, neck full of gold. Bring it to your homeboy, how much drugs you sold. But out the street, homeboy is dumb. Even 12-year-old kids can go out and buy a gun.
They're saying, this is what we live, this is what it's like on the streets. Here it is.
Chilling on the corner ain't committing no crime. Standing here crazy and busting up rhyme. Talking to the girls as they walk by. Man, oh man, do they look fine.
From the street corners of Southeast Atlanta to the concert halls and airwaves of radio and television, rap is the hot language of American culture.
The music sounds good, you know. You'd be washing dishes to it and cleaning house to it, and I like it.
We gon' keep on rocking.
Rap has crept along the periphery of popular music for years. Its roots are traceable to the jazz age, emerging intermittently in the years since in R&B and rock and roll.
Some call it heavenly in its brilliance, others mean and rueful of the Western dream.
Rap isn't new. What's new is how big it's become. Its record sales are huge. And not only in the city. In suburban Atlanta, rap's big beat draws teens together and worried visits from police.
I like the boom and the bass.
How much rap music you listen to?
All the time.
The concept of rap music is pretty simple. A drum machine, a synthesizer, a DJ doing rhythmic violence to the grooves of a record album, and a human voice. It's a vocal performance by artists who might admit they cannot sing a lick.
I can't sing, and I ain't trying to sing, you know, and rapping is a way of speaking about yourself. Rapping is personality.
It is rap's simplicity, its lack of musical pretense, that draws its fans and its critics.
It's gonna be one of the things that'll run into a dead end.
James Tigner is one critic, the founder of an Atlanta record company. Tigner thinks rap will fade because it is not broadening its audience.
I mean, I can find an R&B singer that will sing to me on my level. You can find a country artist that can sing to you on your level. Let's find a rap artist that can rap to me on my level.
So express yourself, yeah. Express yourself.
Rap fans say, listen harder. There is some intelligent, important rap music out there. Rap is not just in record stores and on radio, but in now in television commercials, targeting both white and black audiences. But the rap rage is enraging some.
The main purpose of me showing you this special report from the news is so you can get a general idea of what rap is like today. Basically, everything he said in his report was true, but there are still some misconceptions about rap music. It really didn't start in the late 70s, but it started in 1969 and the early 70s. Rap is one of the most original forms of black music aside from jazz. It takes more than just a voice and a beat. Something else that is as important as the year rap started is place of origin. Rap music didn't originate from pop, rock music, or jazz, but rather the West Indies.
people get the wrong information. They try to say it came from the South Bronx, but it started from the West Bronx with Cool DJ Herc, who was born from Jamaica. That's why a lot of our culture of hip-hop is more close to the reggae, and you hear a lot of reggae played at hip-hop functions, because a lot of our backgrounds, Grandmaster Flash and myself, Cool Herc, are of West Indian background. And a lot of the Zulu Nation, a lot of half of them was a part of the West Indian background, and the others is from down south. And myself, I just built a whole organization around the music.
Welcome to Nation, massive demonstration.
Cool DJ Herc, Grandmaster Flash, and Afrika Bambaataa, just to name a few, are some of the original pioneers of rap. This is where we get most of our information from, because there are no written records. Even though there were many historical events taking place when rap first started, none of the rappers felt the need to rap about any of it. Rap was all about yourself. How good could you talk about yourself? How well could you put someone else down? But now, you can find any and everybody with a message or story about something that is happening in the world today. In the past 5 years, it has been songs about the freedom of South Africa, and now, the freedom of Nelson Mandela, and something that is almost as equally as important, the freedom of James Brown. All through the history of rap, the biggest conflict has been with the lyrics. I think the main reason for this is that it's a reflection of society. It's like looking in a big mirror, and the world doesn't like what it's seeing. It also doesn't like the big beat produced from these small speakers, but that's a whole nother story. Anyway, back to what I was saying. The lyrical composition of a rap artist has a lot to do with the style and message it's trying to get across or convey. On T-Bone Talk today, we will be taking a look at Public Enemy, Digital Underground, and MC Hammer.
I put this together too.
With their infectious rhymes, in-your-face showmanship, and militant lyrics, Public Enemy is leading an assault on mainstream American music. They are best described as rebels without a pause. If P.E. wants to get a message across, whether it be don't do drugs or fight the power, all they have to do is put it in their raps.
She's straight out racist. The sucker was simple and plain.
How the f*** you mean, John Wayne?
Cause I'm black and I'm proud. I'm really the hype cause I'm amped. Most of my heroes don't appear in no stamp. Therefore, look at you looking for nothing but redneck for 400 years of your text.
Don't worry, be happy.
For the number one jam. Damn if I said you could find me right here. Hit it.
Now get you
fucked. Right on.
Come on.
What we got to say?
Yeah.
All your people, don't delay. Make everybody see in order to fight the power that be.
Public Enemy is one of the more political rap groups, and they are followers of Farrakhan. Fear of a Black Planet is the title of their latest LP. With it, P.E. brings yet more messages and remarks about racism. Their second release from this album is 9-1.